Yeah, I don't know. I mean, our expectations are to come out and play, you know, good football, sound, quality, competent football, and compete. You know, it's. I don't know. I'd love to tell you that we have an expectation to win this or win that. I mean, the reality is we just want our guys to work their butts off and play hard and you know, just compete in everything that they do. And after that, I mean, everything will kind of fall into place if they're working hard and they're training hard and putting themselves in a position to be successful. Yeah, I mean, we lost a couple of offensive linemen and on offense and receiver, and obviously you know, our quarterback and Cody Kluwit. But so right now, I mean, scheduling. I mean, Hunter at quarterback. I think Gennard will help us out quite a bit, and I think he's going to play well. And you know, I expect our offensive line guys, the guys that were dressing and playing quite a bit, but weren't starting, and we're still. You know, still musical chairs, I mean, on the offensive line, to be honest with you. At the receiving core, I mean, I think Glowden Mullally is going to step up quite a bit. Had a great summer playing for Team Canada and winning a world championship. And his confidence level is, you know, very high. And I think we're going to see some things from him. Defensively, we lost some interior defensive linemen. But I expect Tommy Grant and Angelo Gentile to step up and play very well for us. They've been having a great camp and... you know, we expect them to continue on that road. Yeah, I mean, there are some good surprises. I mean, Cole Esterbrooks played very well in the preseason game, was a second-year kid, played a little bit last year as a first-year player, but had a great offseason and is primed and ready to go. Unfortunately, he's behind Dale and Cam, so he's going to, you know, have to wait his time. But his opportunities, you know, came in the exhibition game, and he ran the ball very well. Some of our young offensive linemen played well. Ben Smith is playing very well at receiver. And I think Alex Larry and Laurie and Duncan Patterson are playing well at Q, and it's going to be nice to see that battle for second and third at the quarterback spot throughout the course of the year. I think is going to be good. Defensively, you know, Riley Gabriel's playing well in the defensive back spot. you know, Kyle Chappas on the defensive line is playing very well from Horton High School here. So we're enjoying watching these young kids kind of move on, and that's kind of the way we do it. We build them from their first year through their second and third, and you know, by the time they get in their second, third year, they start having an impact. And right now we're reaping the benefits of that with a bunch of fourth and fifth year guys, you know, starting for us. So I think that's kind of, you know, in the cycle, that's where we're at right now. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, one exhibition game I couldn't tell you. You know, we had some starters that played, you know, less than four or five plays. We had some veteran guys take less than double-digit plays. So didn't really get a chance to see a lot of the starters play to kind of find out what our strengths are. You know, we return a lot of players, return our kickers and punters. So, you know, I feel good about that. I think specials is going to be a big deal for us. And Coach McNally's done a heck of a job in the offseason and in training camp to get us ready for that. If we can play well on specials, offense and defense will come around. So special teams is a big part of where we're at right now. I think we should be strong there, but, you know, we'll see. Yeah, no, I mean, it's, you know, who knows? You know, each year it changes, and it's a lot of times, and in the last 5 or 6 years for sure, it's who can stay healthiest the longest. So whoever stays healthiest the longest is going to be successful. Last year we stayed pretty healthy, and we were lucky to come out and win the whole thing. You know, the other teams, you know, that stay healthy are going to have a chance. I think St. Effects was really banged up last year, and it hurt them, especially in the long run. Mount A banged up and it hurt them in the long run. St. Mary's was, you know, a strong team. They stayed healthy and they were there in the end with us. So, you know, I think that's kind of it. I mean, Bishop's, you know, is still kind of the anomaly. I mean, I don't know exactly what we're going to get. I don't know much about their players, and they got new coaching staff other than the head coach. So it'll be interesting to see where they're at. But, I mean, anybody can win this conference, and that's probably the difference than all three of the other conferences, is that anybody can win this one. You pretty well know who's going to win the other three.